Hello everybody, and welcome to a new episode of Let's Play Football Manager. I am Drogas, and I am managing Fidelis Andria. This is our second season in Serie B, after we got promoted. And it's the start of the season, it's the first match of the season against Genoa. So, I want to have you with me when we start the season. Hopefully it will be a good start, but I'm not very sure following the 6-1 defeat against Ascoli. My team simply played nothing. They played nothing. We were absolutely beaten to bare bones with this 6-1. After what we had in my opinion quite an okay preseason with friendlies and with the training, but unfortunately this 6-1 doesn't really go very well. But like I said, we'll have to see what we do in this game, but until then let's see what we've been up to with the transfers. So let's look at transfer history. First of all the out players. This is Alessandro De Fena, our striker slash attacking midfielder. I wasn't going to keep him because of his stats, and I just offered him at 8k to anyone that will want to get it. Get him. Also, those are free transfers. These are just Ciancio, yeah, he was a defender, but Cianelli, I think it's a striker, yeah. He's a striker whom I signed in the first season. Also, Marco Piccini, because of his age, this is the main reason why I didn't renew his contract. Daniel Onescu also, not the age, but I didn't want to renew his contract because he didn't play as much last season, and I would only be keeping one place for register occupied with him, and we brought, I think, better players. This is a winger, young one, who I also didn't renew the contract. Nicola Delino, our defender that we had in the first team, but played him rarely. Davide Muscolino, he was also in the under 20s squad. Luca Gargano, this is our winger and slash striker, our young striker, but also we played him very little. Rizzi, Saverio Rizzi, also came from the under 20s. Leva or Jeva, also came from under 20s. This one also. And now we have Aniello Panariello. If you remember correctly, I think it was also in a few games where I recorded. I'm not really sure, but I am sure that last season he gave away 4 penalties to the other teams. And this is a lot. This is a lot even by my standards. And I told him, okay, you're not good enough. Get out. So I wouldn't play him. The good part was were his technical stats. But his mentals were letting him down and making him commit such fouls. Unfortunately, we had to sell Giorgio Capece because he came to us and said, "Okay, I want to leave, and I want you to accept any offer coming to me." And I didn't accept any offer, but I negotiated and We managed to sell him for 575k. Senna Miange, also our left fullback, but was able to play central defender also. But I've sold him because of the same reason. He was keeping a place in the registration team occupied. I didn't play him as much. I wanted to play also the left fullback that we have. I think we bought him season ago or something. Look, yeah, Pietro Beruato, who is young, he's 20 years old, has fairly good stats, and that's why I wanted to have only two left defenders. Rachid Arma was our striker, our very good striker, but we had him and he's 34 years old, and also he, in my opinion, he had moments when he was out of form, and I couldn't risk that in a season where I want to get as high as I can on the league table. Davide Mansi, also we sold him for 50k, and Raul Zucchetti, now it's only on loan to Forli. Okay, those were the players going out. What about the players coming in? Players coming in, we have Charlie Good. I have to mention all the players are free until I have a good bank to work with. I cannot afford any other type of players, that's why I will only work with free players, because all the good players that I would want are very expensive, and we don't we're not able to make any deals with them except there if they're free. So we have our central defender, Charlie Good. What I like about him is the fact that his jumping is 17, and the stats at heading, marking and tackling are 14. Not very good mentals, but fairly okay. I'm hoping, because he's 24, those stats will grow. Another central defender, Aaron Hayden, and I brought him as a completion in the central area of the pitch, because as you can see, his mentals are quite okay, above average, physicals also. At the technical, he only has 12 and 13 at heading, marking and tackling, but he can grow there through training, and yeah, also he's young, that's why I bought him. Now we have our striker, Maxime Pelican. He's a French one, 21 years old, very good stats for this age, good determination, good finishing, good acceleration and pace, and good teamwork and work rate. So I'm looking forward to see him play. In the first cup match he scored, but after that he got injured. We had him injured in the last 3 or 4 weeks or something. We have Andria Scrugli from Akragas. He's a right fullback. We bought him as a substitute. Also have Bobby Grant, our left winger, in order to replace Strambelli if he has to. Domenico Botalico, this one, I think he's a youngster. Yeah, I think I have him in the under 20s. Yeah, he was a player. Yeah, I remember what's about him. He was a player. I didn't renew the contract, and in June, when the contract expired, I wanted to offer him a new contract, and unfortunately I clicked on release and I released the player, and only after that I was able to make a new offer to sign. Another good midfielder is Nicolas Viola, also a free transfer, but good determination, good flair, good passing, also good dribbling and first touch, so he will play for us quite often. Mattia Zaccagni, also central midfielder, that can play in three positions: advanced, normal midfielder, or defensive. Good flair, excellent flair actually, and good, very good determination. I'm really excited about him. We managed to get Mateus again on loan. As you can see, he was with us 2 seasons ago in Serie C when we got promoted. After that, he didn't want to come to us. He went to Avellino. But I know the striker, and I'm okay with working with him. Young striker. Unfortunately, now he's injured. He was injured for 2 months. So, and Roberto Gagliardini, our last transfer. We only brought him because I saw that the team had 22 players, so I said, okay, we need another. Actually, I think it was 24 players, but I brought him because I said that we might need another central midfielder. So this is the team. We will play with Müller starting goal, Salviato right fullback, Good and Bedushi. Good is the one that has the jumping, the good jumping and heading. Antonio Mazzotta will be on the left. Savas will play as defensive midfielder. And we have right midfielder Marcel Avdic. Central, we have Viola and Guito. In the left, I think I would play with Strambelli. And attacking, we have Virginio De Vita. I would like to put Pelican. Let's try with Pelican. Yeah. And we also have Bobby Grant. Should we put Bobby Grant? What are his stats here? Fairly good. One Muniz. Now let's play with Muniz and see what happens. What is his speed? Basically the same as last season. Okay. So now we will go into the game. Because of all the talking I've did, it will be only one match in this episode. But it was a match with an overview of the transfers I've made and the thoughts that made me do those transfers. Okay, so they play a classic 4-4-2. Let's see what specific instruction can we give to this team. And they have concentration. Oh, very low concentration. It's okay. Good. Oh, nice. Nice, nice, nice. Bravery. Good. Bravery. Good. Ooh, nice mental stats for this team. Very good mental stats. We'll just go with this. He's a poacher, 17 years old. If you want to play him, you're in big trouble. Kalapai, what is he? He's a fullback. Amari, concentration, he's a winger. Okay. He enters. Defensive, okay, he's a left one. Asensio, is that? No, he's not the one. Concentration, okay. And bravery. We can also attack at his bravery. And we have Benali. Concentration also. Sissoko, Fabio Duarte. Oh, nice. Okay, let's go to our Where I give a performance to cheer for. Okay, now I see we're playing away. Should have paid more attention to that detail. And the second season in Serie B starts with this game. Let's see what we can do. Let's see what we can do. Okay, they had a few shots. We also had 3 shots, so that's good. Less possession, but now they have a corner. I hope they don't score. No, we managed to clear it, but they have it in position. Pass in the center, and they're trying to. Oh, it's a throw-out pass, but we managed to clear it. Have to be honest, we were lucky there. Okay, let's try with a counter-attack. I'm far from pleased. Okay. Counter. Let's try like this, at least for a few minutes, to see how it works. I'm curious to see if we can get him on the fast counter-attack. Oh, nice. Have a corner. And it's a goal! Good scores on his debut. That's why I bought him. That's why I bought him. Because of the set piece. Because at corners he can jump very, very high and he can score those headers. Excellent. And it's a penalty. What a good change of tactics and strategy to go on the counter. Because otherwise I'm very sure that they would have scored. Okay, Muniz with oh, nice, right in the top corner. We're leading with 2-0. And appears to be a very good start of the season. We have 9 shots on towards the goal, which is very good. I'm very happy with those stats. Let's change Viola with Zakani, but Zakani has to be box to box, and Muniz I will to change with Strambelli. Okay. Muniz also ran in the last match, so he ran quite a lot. I think I'll have to change also Guido because of his stats. Okay, let's try and change Guido. Yep, and that's it. I'm not even gonna say anything else, and we basically won. It's a 2-0. I don't think they're gonna have time to make 2-1, but we won. We got the 3 points. We got them away. We got them also in the start of the season, so I have so many reasons to be satisfied and happy. Yeah, definitely gonna say that. And also Muniz, I have to tell him that I'm very happy. Just leave it like this. It seems not to have anything. So we won. We won our first game. And we're in a good position after this start of the season. Hopefully this is how the league table will look at the end of the season, maybe with us higher, but we can only hope for. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed what you saw, please leave a like. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below, and I'll be happy to answer to you. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.